What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to the channel. Given it today with another Destiny 2 video for you. How the hell are you all doing? Thank you for stopping by. Yes, I have decided to skip back into Iron Banner and have a bit of fun with it. Using Lord of Memes, I watched some videos on it and it looked like it was easy kill gun. I didn't find it that easy to kill with, probably because I suck balls. But what you'll notice is that I change up my weapons quite exponentially while I'm playing. I tend not to stick to a particular weapon and just kind of mess around with it and play how I play. Now, I am renaming this this Iron Banner session. Not just Iron Banner anymore, I would call it Iron Banner season, whatever we're on, 7, I think it is now. And I would call it AKA Pulse Rifle the Movie, because it is appearing to me like Pulse Rifles are the absolute meta when it comes to Iron Banner at the moment. When you get into your sweaty six stacks and everything, a lot of people are using the Pulse Rifles, so Bygones, Outbreak, all of that kind of stuff is what you generally tend to find, or what I found I was getting killed with quite a lot. Not only that, you've got people that are using Recluse, Not Forgotten, usual stuff. You've got the usual pinnacle weapons that people put in when they go to sweaty thick stack and trying to destroy everybody. And I didn't do Iron Banner last season, and the main reason for that was because I couldn't couldn't be bothered is probably the wrong word for it, really. I didn't feel like I wanted to put myself in that sort of stressful situation. Now, I'll be the first to admit, when I've been playing Iron Banner, that it's been, I've found that that the game's improved quite drastically in terms of the matchmaking, in terms of the way that it's played. Now, that kind of rings true in the games that I'm playing in this one. They were relatively close. They weren't where we absolutely, you know, rumple stomp people and we got away with a load of stuff and it was just rolling teams over consistently all the time. It felt like the games were close and enjoyable to play. And that's, for me, that's the main thing when you're playing Iron Banner is that, yeah, it's nice to absolutely shit on people on occasion, but then also what you have to remember is that you want it to be a challenge, you want it to be fun, you want it to be a good game, you want it to be where you're having to try, not try hard to the point where you're having to absolutely sweat your nuts off and intravenously insert gamma labs into your system just so you can concentrate whilst popping Adderall at the same time as well. But you want it to be a bit of a challenge, you don't want it to be, you know, super easy. And obviously light level is a big factor in this. And I just had fun with it. And, you know, as I said in my last video, and thank you so much as well for the support on the last video. You know, I don't put a video up for nearly a month, and it receives really good views, so I'm genuinely touched by that. And, you know, I've got messages and stuff and things, so that's great. So obviously with my situation with Alfie being here now and having to be responsible for a baby is changing the amount of time that I can sit down and play the game. So it's kind of me just picking the game up and playing it a couple of hours here and a couple of hours there, and just try to grind the best that I can. So what I'm generally trying to do is do all the stuff that's going to give me the high light level as quickly as possible. I think I'm currently at 721, going from about 700 at the start of the week, just by grinding, you know, trying to grind all the power ammo and everything, all the power engrams as quickly as humanly possible, or as I said, as quickly as I can to get stuff sorted out and allow me to do the things that I need to do to get to light level 750. And I've been playing the menagerie, and the funny thing is that as your light level's getting higher, or my light level's gotten higher, it's not as you get shit on straight away sort of thing, and I enjoy it. The menagerie is an absolutely phenomenal addition to this game. It's great fun to play, it's great to get the runes in, you know, into your chalice, and it's great to try and to put the runes in and trying to get the weapon that you want to get. I keep getting midnight talons for some reason, I don't know why. It's just midnight talons, that's a shader. I keep getting a sniper rifle, the Dreaming City sniper rifle. I can't remember the name of it, shows how much I actually play this game. But there's that little glitch that you can do where you've got like 200 and some odd seconds to finish the game, so you can run out of the room and run back in again. As long as you've put the rune in, you can keep opening the chest to try and get a weapon that you want to get. And I'm desperately trying to get the Ostringer. I really want that weapon. I've seen it being used and it's a lot of good fun. The one thing that I have noticed that there hasn't been as much of, or that maybe I've just been lucky in terms of the lobbies that I've gotten into, but I don't seem to have been coming across as much Luna's Howl as what you would normally come across him when you get into Iron Banner and it being absolutely super sweaty. I have had some connection issues, I'm not going to lie, not from my end, just with people that I've been playing against. They just seem to be sort of rubber banding around about the place, and that absolutely, you know, comical thing of being shot through the wall side of things is always quite an enjoyable, funny thing to experience, but it's been okay. Like I said, it's been fun, and I don't know if anybody else has noticed this. I know a lot of people bitch about Titans and One-Eyed Mask and all of that kind of stuff, but I have never played PvP and been marked for vengeance as many times as I have whilst playing Iron Banner this time around. It just seems to be, you know, a constant thing, and I'm just amazed at how much that actually happens. It is actually quite funny, because what you do is you find yourself playing really passively, because you think any minute now some Titan is going to come skating around the corner and either shoulder charge me or shotgun ape me. It's just comical, but it's Iron Banner. It's one of them things, if you want to do well in the game, then you have to adapt and overcome and try and work a little bit better. One of the things that I've noticed is Jotun doesn't seem to be, or the Yeet-mobile, doesn't seem to be as toxic as what it was. A lot of people seem to have learnt that if you jump round and behind a wall, you're less likely to get hit by it. I don't know why it took people so long to work that one out, but it's there now, it's happening, so it's not as bad as what it originally once was, shall we say. But yeah, overall, enjoying it, enjoying Iron Banner, I'm enjoying the grind. This rocket launcher that I've got has got tracking on it, which is good fun. I used it in Gambit and it was hilarious because I just kept in invading and rocket launching people. It looks nice as well, actually. I like the colourway on it. I've not changed it. I usually change the shade on it, but I've not done it this time around, just purely because, well, I haven't. The blast radius on this rocket launcher is really good as well. So again, it's just enjoyment that I've been having overall whilst playing Iron Banner, and I'm glad that I didn't play last season, because by all accounts it was very, very sweaty and very, very annoying at the same time as well. So yeah, overall having fun. Let me know how you've been getting on with Iron Banner. Have you been enjoying it? What are you grinding for? Are you finding that the PvP experience has been quite good? I'm interested in trying the new raid, because I want to try the raid weapons. Watch the video that Frostbolt did where he was using raid weapons in PvP, and some of them looked pretty beastly, and some of the rolls that he had on them looked incredibly beastly at the same time as well. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. Just real quick sort of little update. I wanted to try and keep consistency and get another video up this week. So hopefully you've enjoyed it. If you have, please don't forget to click the like button. If you're new to the channel, please also don't forget to subscribe. This has been Gibbon with another Destiny 2 video. Thank you very much for stopping by, and we're out of here. Peace. Jackson.